Hi everybody, welcome to the distributive property lecture, and tonight we're going to be taking a look at the distributive property and how it helps us deal with variables when PEMDAS doesn't allow us to combine terms inside the parentheses. So I'm just going to go through a couple of quick examples. We'll have plenty of time to practice in class tomorrow. For some of you, you've seen this before. For some of you, you've seen it and have forgotten the skill. So please, just take good notes. Just think about what's happening if these were real numbers versus numbers with variables. How would you deal with it then? And I think if you do that, then you'll understand that, oh, okay, all I'm doing here is multiplying. So with that said, let's get started on how the distributive property works and how it helps us deal with variables. So if we were doing a math problem such as the first one, but instead of 5x minus 9 we had 5 minus 9, well obviously we would do 5 minus 9 and get negative 4 and then multiply it by the negative 5. But because this is a 5x and this is a number 9, there is no way we can combine those two components. One is 5 times x, which we don't know, and then we're subtracting 9 from it. There is no way to combine those two terms. But we want to simplify this. So really what the distributive property tells us is that this 5, this negative 5, is multiplying the 5x. And it's also multiplying this component right here, the negative 9. So let's take a look at what that means. Well, it means that this negative 5 times this 5x will give me negative 25x. Negative 5 times 5 is 25. Negative 5x, this is combined together, so these components remain combined together. Here's the second component. This is a negative 9. We have a negative 5 times a negative 9. 5 times 9 is 45. Negative times a negative is a positive. We end up with negative 25x plus 45. Very straightforward. Okay, well, are we limited to the number of times that we can do this? Well, here we have a 4 times this, and a 4 times this, and a 4 times this. The parentheses say that everything inside here is being multiplied by what is outside. So in this particular case, everything is going to be 4 times bigger when we're done with it. So we have 4 times 2x is 8x. 4 times negative 10, which is negative 40. And 4 times 2p, which is 8p. Can we combine the 8x and the 8p? We'll talk about that more in our next lesson, but think about it. This is 8 apples and this is 8 pears. Do we have 16 apple pears? No. So those aren't going to be able to be combined. Some things that I really want to make sure you do. It's not 4 times 2 and 4 times x. It's 4 times 2x. Think of this as 2 cases of apples. And now we're going to get 4 times that. So now how many cases of apples do we have? Well, we have 4 times 2 is 8 cases of apples. 4 times the negative 10 is 40. And then let's say this is cases of pears. Right now we have 2 cases of pears. And we're going to multiply that number by 4. So then we end up with 8 cases of pears. Remember, this is just the number of p, the number of x. And we'll talk a little bit more about that tomorrow. Make sure we're okay with that. All right. So, third problem we have here. Well, here it looks like we have a variable times a variable. So what am I going to do with this? Well, this is 4n times n and 4n times negative 3. We just learned that. So what has really changed? Well, let's write it. We have 4. 4n is really 4 times n, right? 4 times n, 4n. And then we're multiplying that times n. So this is multiplying by n. So 4 times n, and that whole thing is multiplying by the n, so that's there. So what's a good way of writing it? Well, we can still write the 4, but anything times itself, how can that be written? 3 times 3 can also be written as 3 squared. So n times n can be written as n squared. So 4n to the n times n is 4n squared, and you'll get quicker at that. And then 4n times, please be careful, this is a negative 3. So 4 times negative 3 is negative 12n. Don't drop the n. 4n times this is now negative 12n. Great. All right, and our last example that we're going to take a look at tonight is the dreaded just the negative. What does that mean? Well, you can look at this a couple of different ways, but I think the easiest way to look at that is the fact that whenever we don't write something, there's something hidden. There's something underlying that we don't really write. We have 2x. We have 3x, we have 4x. When I come up here and I write x, do I need to write the 1? Well, I don't really need to write that 1, do I? It's just understood that there is 1x. If I write negative 2x, negative 3x, this is negative what? What's really written here that we didn't right, but we know it exists? Well, it's negative 1. So what do you think this means over here? Well, this means really negative 1 times 2p times negative 8. And once you've got that, that's easy then. Now we got negative 1 times 2 is negative 2p. Negative 1 times negative 8. Negative times a negative is a positive 8. And we're done. And so hopefully you'll get quicker at that and you won't have to go through that big math row. But anytime it's written like that, negative parentheses, it really means negative 1. I mean, I guess we could take a look at this. There's a positive here. We don't even write the positive. 2p minus 8. Positive 1 times 2p, a positive times negative 8, still gives me the exact same thing. So the other way some of you fast learners will get it is all we did here was really the 2p became negative 2p and the negative 8 became positive 8. So this negative just means flip the sign. All right. If there is a quiz, you can find the quiz under quiz 12. Not sure if I've even posted one. And I hope that makes a lot of sense for you. You can see the power of the distributive property. You'll be doing a lot more of these. Go to the quiz if I did post it on quiz 12, and I will see you in class tomorrow.